Hello class 5, hope you all are fit and fine. So let's start our online science class, and we are continuing the chapter 10, our universe. Through our previous classes we already learned that our mother planet Earth is a part of the solar system. Whenever we see over our head in an open area, we can see the vast sky, that is the endless space. Many of us see or feel heaven is somewhere up there. For that reason, all objects in the sky are called as heavenly bodies or celestial bodies. Actually, space is infinite. That means never ending in the universe. And our Earth is just a little dot in the vast universe. Stars are the only heavenly bodies which give off their own heat and light. There are many stars in the universe. They are actually the stars, they are actually huge balls of gases located far away in the universe. For that, they are looking very small. Can you remember the nursery rhymes? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Really, we wondered. The sun is a star, you know, but because it is comparatively nearer to the Earth, our planet Earth, so we find it quite big than the other stars. The solar system is the system of the sun. It contains 8 planets, their satellites, some dwarf planets, meteors, comets, etc. Now, what is planet? Planet is a heavenly body that revolves around a star. And what is satellite? Satellites are heavenly or celestial body which revolve around a planet. So this is to remember, you always remember this fact, that planet always revolve around the star and the satellites revolve around the planet. We can say solar system is the family of the sun, and sun is head of the family, and 8 planets in solar system are its 8 family members. In order to distance from the sun, 8 planets are, can you remember the sentence? My very easy method just speeds up nothing. So in order to distance from the sun, 8 planets are, yes, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. And Pluto is the dwarf planet. So our Earth is the 3rd planet from the sun, and it is the only planet in solar system which supports life. Like other planets, shape of the Earth is sphere. You know, 2/3 of the Earth's surface is covered with water, and only one part is land. And Earth is our home planet, all of you know, and our home planet is wrapped with a blanket of air that is called as atmosphere. And the atmosphere has many layers, you know. Now about the outer cover and inner part of the Earth. If we were to cut open the Earth, we would find three layers: crust, mantle, and core. As I told you before, you can just compare our Earth with an egg. And crust is the outermost solid layer of the Earth, just like the boiled egg, there is a outer part which is hard enough. Crust is the outermost solid layer of the Earth where we live. We live on the crust, and all the biosphere is on the crust. All living organisms, plants are on the crust. And mantle is the second layer inside the Earth. That is just like the you know, the boiled egg has a white part. This is mantle. Suppose it is mantle. And temperature is very high there in mantle. And it is semi-solid. Mantle is semi-solid, not totally solid. And next is core. Core is the innermost layer at the very center of the Earth. In a boiled egg, the yellow part, the yolk, that is, you can compare it to the core. The core of the Earth is divided into two sections: outer core and inner core. You can see in this picture, in this diagram. Okay, so these are all about the Earth. Now let's know about the Sun, head of the solar family. The Sun is at the center of a huge solar system. It attracts all heavenly bodies. All heavenly bodies means all the planets, its satellites, their planets and their satellites, comets, asteroids, everything. How the Sun attracts all these heavenly bodies? With its strong gravitational force. For that, all the eight planets, their satellites, asteroids, comets, remain within its area. And you know, each and every planet and satellites have their own path, and the fixed path. All of them have their own fixed path, and this path is called as orbit. Our own star, Sun, is a huge ball of fire and gases. Can you imagine how big is it? If a hollow Sun was filled up with spherical earths, then around 960,000 Earths would fit inside. Really, it is beyond our imagination. We just can't imagine how big is the Sun. The Sun is also spherical in shape, as all other heavenly bodies in space. The Sun is also spherical in shape and is said to have the same age as the solar system. Scientists believe it is 4.5 billion years old. Remember, scientists believe it, the sun is 4.5 billion years old. All the 8 planets in the solar system, including Earth, revolve around the sun. As Earth is located within area that is such a distance from the sun that is not too near or not too far, for that temperature and light of the sun here on Earth is balanced and supports life. So we can say that nothing is more important to us on Earth than the sun. Without the sun's heat and light, the Earth would be a lifeless ball of ice-coated rock. The sun warms our seas, steers our atmosphere, generates our weather patterns, and gives energy to the growing green plants that provide the food and oxygen for life on Earth. The food chain will be impossible without the sun. Sun is the base of our food chain. And our Earth is life will be lifeless without the sun. So it is most important. Sun is most important to us. Always remember that. Sun is the source of energy on Earth. You know, there are 3 outer layers of the sun. Those are corona, the chromosphere, and then photosphere. There are other inner layers of the sun. You can see here in this diagram. And the innermost layer is called as core, just like our Earth. The innermost layer is called as core. And the temperature is very, very high in the inner part. Corona is the thin layer of atmosphere of sun, which we sometimes see during an eclipse. Whenever a solar eclipse occur, we can see full solar eclipse occur, then we can see the corona, a faint just lined part which we see during a solar eclipse, that is called as ring of fire. The sun actually consists of gases like hydrogen and helium. With great pressure, hydrogen changes into helium and so release a lot of heat, light and energy, which we call as solar energy. Solar energy is very important for us, as I told you before. Always remember that solar energy is the source of life on Earth. Without that, our Earth will be a lifeless, cold planet. And you know, the sun has some dark spots. This area of spots are not so hot as the other parts. So the spots which we can see, dark spots which we can see on the sun, are the areas that are not so hot as the other parts. And the other features of the sun's surface are solar flares. Actually, solar flares which we can see whenever we see to the sky, and then we can see the solar flares. They are huge flames actually projecting outwards from the sun's surface. And you know, the light from the sun takes about 8 minutes to reach to the earth. The light and heat which we get from the sun, it takes about 8 minutes to reach on the earth. And an important fact is, heat from the center of the sun takes a million years to reach its surface. From the center to surface of the sun, it takes a million years to reach the heat. However, once the heat leaves the sun's surface, it takes only 8 minutes to reach the earth. So, these are all about sun. So, that's all for today. In my next class, I'll discuss about the moon. Okay? So, you all stay safe till my next class. Bye.